Welcome back to PJ Chen Design. This is PJ. Today we are going to make this pair of eyewear and also a jewelry box by using the laser engraving machine from Longer Ray 5. Are you ready? Let's get started. To finish this project for the eyewear and jewelry box, we need three components. First, we need a laser engraving and cutting machine, and we also need laser cutting software from Lightburn, and then it's the material that you wish to cut here. After receiving the longer ray laser cut machine, I unbox it, and it took me about 30 to 40 minutes to assemble it together. The instruction is really clear and easy to follow. It comes with all the tools that you needed, so it doesn't take too long to put it up together. You can download the Lightburn software at lightburnsoftware.com. It gives you 30 days to use for free. I personally like its interface. It's really easy to follow, and the interface is really similar with other software that we are using for design. Once the machine is ready and the laser cut software is ready, I'm going to cut some square here to test out what is the speed and the power I should use to cut this 2.8 millimeter balsa wood sheet. This eyewear is pretty simple. There's only a few parts right there. You can see this is the front and this is the temple. So all we need to pay attention is this locking piece right there. They are cutting out from the same material, and then you can see I have a slot a little bit lower right there, and I will have this one coming in back there and locking in there. So we need to extract all the line over here. First of all, you're going to have this one, and we're gonna coming into the solid extruded planar curve straight, and we want to extrude it for 2.8 millimeter, which is our material thickness. Once you have this one done, you can come in over here for the temple that you have. And then again, we want to extrude it the same thickness right there. Now you have this connected to each other. The next step is need to cutting the hole out for this extension coming out and have that locking system right there. So once we have those two parts, I'm going to lock in this one so it's not bothering you to see what I'm working here. We need to pick up the edge right there. So let's go ahead to use Control Shift and pick up using the gumball to pick up these faces. And we want to extrude it from there. I want to extrude it the same thickness of the material but in opposite direction, so minus 2.8. I'm going to extrude it one more time by picking up these faces right there with the Control Shift with the gumball, and I'm going to extrude it one more time. So this is where where the locking system is right there. I'm going to extrude one more time for again 2.8 millimeter. Next things we wanted to do is want to make that stopper. So I'm gonna coming over here. I'm going to creating some sort of a corner with my rectangle, and I'm going to making the shape look like this and a little bit rounded there. With this one, I'm going to move it close to the center. I to use a solid extruded planar curve straight for 2.8 millimeter about right here. So this is where be that locking system over there. All we need to do now is cutting out somewhere in the middle. So let's go ahead to use with the 3 point. And so first point roughly right here, second point right here. And then we're gonna go a little bit deeper right there. This is going to be the cutting tool for us. And to do the boolean difference of this one out of this one. And that's making a copy. Control C, Control V. So we have two of the temple right here, and let's go ahead just hiding one of them. So what we need to do is boolean difference this eyewear frame and also this cutter by this temple. Now you can see it cut it out exactly the same shape over there. If this shape it doesn't look too good for you to be like a too harsh there, you can simply just giving a fit of edges. We want to fit the edges this one and also the bottom one for two there. So it will be a little bit rounder, it will look nicer. To get the shape that we need, we can coming into the one that we have for the curve and also for the lenses right there. This is the one we are going to use as a curve. So I'm going to move it out right there. That's for the laser cut. This one, I'm going to move it out here, and to show you how to get in the curve, we can simply just coming over and using a duplicate edges, and we want to duplicate edges of this edges right there. And this is the curve that we are going to do for the laser cut. Notice that there's a line going inside, which we don't need it. So let's go ahead to delete all three of them and make sure that you join them so you don't accidentally to move them. So I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees over here and bring this one here. And also bring it down right here. And we also need to duplicate this shape right here. So now after arrange everything together, then we'll get this line ready for the laser cut. I will have this for you to download at the description below. Sign up a newsletter. You can get this file in a Lightburn so you can laser cut it directly. After all the line work from the Rhino, I export it into the Illustrator file and import into the Lightburn software. After doing multiple different square of the testing on the cut, I find out the best cutting speed for the line is 250 millimeter with the 100% power, and just one pass should be enough to cut through 2.8 millimeter balsa wood sheet. I later on cut out another one with the metal honeycomb in the back, and it does help to make the laser cut doesn't flash back, so the wood doesn't have much of the burning mark compared to the one that I have on a flat acrylic sheet. One thing I would like to mention during my experiment, it depends on the material that you're cutting. Some of them is really gonna have a lot of smoke, so it better in the area is really having a good ventilation area. Otherwise, I would suggest you wear mask and hopefully it's not smoking your house too much. The assemblage is quite simple. You don't need any glue or any other material to hold it together. The key that we design over there, it's good for locking them together. Since I have a full extra piece for the key to cut there, just in case if it break it, you have something spare to use. So this is the final result. It's actually pretty sturdy. To make my second design here for the jewelry box, I will need to have a few components. First, I need to testing for the laser cutting and also the laser engraving for the logo. And then I need to have this live hinge test here. So that's starting those tests. With the Lightburn, I have this engraving test here. What I do is I set up three rows of the square, and each of them is go from 10% to 100% power. And the first one for the engraving is 1000 cm per millimeter, and then it go up to 12,000 and 14,000. You can download this file at the description below. I will have this file for you to use. So let's take a look on the result here. As soon as I starting the engraving, I know that 100 power is the setting on 1000 centimeter is way too dark. And very quickly, I can adjust the second test to be more middle range. So I don't need to have this really burned down engraving over there. So this is my test. The second test, I bump up to 3500 centimeter. Up to 4500 centimeter, and testing only the power above 60% power, and I end up liking somewhere in between 3500 centimeter per minute. The color looked nice to me, so I'm going to stick with this setup. I also do the cutting test for 1.5 millimeter thickness and end up liking. So the result for 400 millimeter with the 100% power, it's the best result for 1.5 millimeter balsa wood sheet. I found this really useful website for curved laser bend wood. It has all different kind of template for you to download and to show you what is the theory behind the bending wood. I will leave the link at the description below for you to download it if you're interested to having those pattern. I end up testing three different type of the pattern from the file that I download online and putting into the frame is similar with the size I'm going to design for my jewelry box. The setting for this cutting is 400 millimeter per minute with 100% power, and just do one pass will be fine. Notice that some of the line is not super straight. It's because the sheet that I have was really thin, and it wasn't probably because the moisture, it wasn't leave in the condition like super dry, so it's a little bit bended on the surface of the wood sheet. After the laser cut, I was doing some bending test and realized one of the set right here is really easy to break, and I end up liking the other two. I might want to use both of them to see the result and which one is going to fit my jewelry box better. The jewelry box design is quite simple. In this design, I have the key interlocking each other. That is the same idea like the eyewear, so I'm not going to repeat it here. The only thing that we wanted to pay attention is we want everything flat. So specific on this one, we need to know how we're going to flatten it. First of all, I'm going to extract the surface, and I'm just, for your convenience, I'm going to move it outside here so easier for you to see. Then we are going to use the command called unroll surface, and that is going to unroll into this sheet right here. This will be the sheet for us to do the laser cut, but we only need to have the curve instead of the whole surface. So that's using duplicate edges, and then we're gonna pick up the whole things, and then we're gonna move it to the side, and this will be the area all the line work for us to cut out from that sheet. This also is the area I'm going to arrange my life hinges. So I end up having a line going into this way, having the pattern arranged here. I'm going to cut out two patterns and see which one worked the best, and all of them should be perfectly to fit each other in order to glue together. Again, you can download this file at the description below with the other file together. Before you start cutting your object, I always like to know what exactly size of the material that I'm using that is accurate to align. So what I like to do is set it up the speed pretty high, but the power only use 1% here. So I will see a laser light go around my material, so at least I will make sure that it's the right place to cut. One thing I like to mention here, it is for this pattern cutting, since it is really intensive cutting, there will be a lot of smoke. You might notice that I have a bed here behind the board. This is the bed that I ordered from Amazon, which is going to help the laser beam is not bounce back to my material, so the bag won't be like a burning mark over there. I intended to cut out two different type of the pattern and see which one come out better. You might need to adjust the width and also the pattern in between the piece. Depends on the material for how thick the material that you are cutting. Basically, the faster speed it's going to cut lighter, and the lower speed it's going to cut deeper, but the lower speed at the same time might burning the material. In some cases, you might need to have a faster speed and cutting two paths instead. So this is the final result after I gluing all the parts together. One of the features that I like in longer Ray 5 engraving machine is the ability to have the touch screen, and then it is really clear in color, which you don't have to connect it to the computer all the time. You can use the SD card, which is included into the package, and then to do the adjustment, selecting the file, and do the engraving, completely control from the touch screen. I did another test with anodized aluminum sheet. You can buy them from the Amazon most of the time for business card making, and the result come up really nice. So I wanted to see what is the setup for other type of the tests on different type of material. I contact the support. They are really fast response. Within 24 hours, they send me this sheet over here. It has a list of the possible material that you can use on this machine and have its setting with the Lightburn. You can screenshot right here so you can keep this setting with you if you intended to try those material. At the end of the testing, I would like to say I enjoy the testing process, cutting a lot of fun projects besides making jewelry. They are actually running the promotion until June 30th. I'll leave the discount coupon code at the description below and also the link that you can purchase it. Thank you for watching. Hope you're enjoying this type of a testing video. If you'd like to see more, please leave the comment below. See you next week.